There aren't many brands that invent new products simply because they enjoy pushing their creativity limits. Well, one such company that does do it is iFootage. Now, years ago when I adapted my first slider, it was actually the Shark Slider from iFootage. It was solidly built but light at the same time and easy to travel with. It just simply worked. Since then, I've used various other great products from iFootage, like their tripods. Their latest release is the Shark Slider Nano. It's a compact and motorized slider with two axes of movement. It's only 16 inches long, yet it can move the camera to almost twice that length when mounted on a tripod because of the opposing moving baseplate. Setting up a motorized shot with the Shark Slider Nano is very quick. You attach it to a tripod, or if you're setting it up on the ground, you can use the adjustable legs to get it level. And then you put in the battery. The slider accepts Sony NPF style batteries. You can also power it using an external power source, like a battery bank, by connecting it to the USB-C port. Make sure to disable the slider lock before starting the unit. Then long press the power button to turn it on. Once the slider powers up, it will go through an initial calibration process. You'll be able to see how far along the calibration is by looking at the display. The slider actually has a touch screen that you can use to control it. It's very responsive and easy to use. You can also use the iFootage Moco app for Android and iOS to control the slider remotely, but honestly, I personally prefer not having to rely on a phone. So this touch screen that they included in the slider is the best thing ever. Personally, I wish every motorized slider had this. You can pick if you want to do video, time-lapse, or stop motion. You can also adjust different settings in here. Now, to do a motorized slider move, just press the quick start option and then press both the power and function buttons. This will enter the quick gesture learning mode, which makes setting up various moves very fast. You literally put the camera in the position and pan angle you want and then press the A button to confirm that as your keyframe. And then you move the camera to another position and press the B button and then confirm it by pressing OK. After that, you can select if you'd like to swap the two points or if you want to move the loop indefinitely. Then press Origin. The slider will go to its first position, and now you are ready to start recording. You can of course stop the camera move at any point and adjust its speed. You select how many seconds you want the slider to move from point A to point B, or you can again press the power and function button so you can quickly set up a new move. It's very simple and fast. This is perhaps what I love the most about the slider. You do not have to fumble with your phone or learn some complex ways to set up a camera move. You literally just put the camera where you want it to be and set that as one of the positions. That's it. The slider can carry a camera and lens combo of up to 3.5 kilograms when it's in the desktop mode. Now, it can carry up to 2.5 kilograms when it's mounted on a tripod. You can also use the slider in a vertical position to create crane-like shots. Now, in this setup, just be aware that the weight limit is 2 kilograms. The motors are so quiet, they are virtually silent, so there's no need to worry about sound. And also, the slider uses smooth, three-phase brushless DC motors, and combined with the 32-bit high-precision float-point arithmetic processing chip, this slider produces very smooth shots, even when it is used in a macro setup on a 105mm lens. It is always smooth, regardless if you are moving at both slow and fast speeds. If you are doing time-lapse, the slider actually comes with shutter release cables. There's even a phone mount included, since you can use the iFootage Moco app to record directly on your phone. If you are using it in camera mode, then you can use the app to remotely control the slider in real time. And when you get the slider, you will also get a protective carrying case with a battery and all the cables you need. The iFootage team is actually working on some more improvements to the slider, like camera tracking and ability to set up more than just two keyframe positions. This means that this already fun and easy to use slider will only become even more of a powerful filmmaking tool. Anyways, I'm Tom Antos, and if you guys want to keep up to date with any of the future improvements to the Shark Slider Nano, or if you want to see the latest filmmaking news, tips, and tutorials, then don't forget to head on over to my website at tomantosfilms.com and subscribe to my newsletter. See you later!